We're having this conversation outside, yes. Dr. Maria Wright and I. It's all about pediatricians and getting those tests in for kids who are going back to school.
That's correct.
Yeah, we're just talking. Thanks for joining us, Theo, and the rest of you at home. Okay, so Dr. Wright, you work in this field, so you know how
yes.
it goes. People try to get their appointments in for those last-minute vaccines.
Yes.
Right away, but you really do have to give doctors some time to catch up.
Yeah, the thing is that there's usually a high demand right about this time, and I recommend that parents call early. Call 2 to 3 months ahead of time so you can find out if you need shots, if you need a physical, forms. That's the best time to get it all done the way you want it done.
Well, that poses an important question, though. A lot of parents are looking at going back to school this week. The
yes.
kids are already starting classes again,
yes.
or they might be starting at the end of the month. If you have been procrastinating, for those parents at home watching, what's the best thing to do?
Call the pediatrician anyways. The thing is, every year it's the same thing. Just do it early.
Mm-hmm.
That's the best thing to do, because then otherwise we're trying to accommodate you as best we can, and sometimes we can't.
And a lot of people know how to get those preschool and kindergarten vaccines checked off the list.
Yes.
The schools heavily advertise them. But for children who are in older grades, guys, I know you guys are doing the preschool ones on the screen right now for us, but let's skip ahead a couple of grades. For high schoolers, what do they need to watch out for?
Well, the sports physicals. And that's the big thing in August. And so usually at that age, we make sure they've had their tetanus, pertussis, booster, and their meningitis vaccine.
Mm-hmm. So it's really important to keep them up to date with the physicals.
That's correct.
And then the same thing for middle school. So you guys are still going to be dealing with a lot of those sports physicals.
Yes.
Whether they're in football or whether they're a cheerleader.
Yes, yes. And so, again, coming in, making sure you can get in and get that sports physical form filled out is important.
Do you think a lot of people, I mean, from what I've understood, the forecast is that more people are going to be going in to the doctor while they still have health benefits,
mm-hmm.
while they're still employed.
Mm-hmm.
But for some families who are looking at maybe an income cap as to what they can afford in terms of getting their babies checked out. What is something that's vital that no matter what, if you have, you know, if you've got to use your Medi-Cal, Medicaid, or you have a formal health insurance, what's the one thing that parents cannot live without doing for testing right now?
I would say vaccines,
mm-hmm.
you know, just making sure your child is up to date on the vaccines. And after that, the blood work.
They're not
anemic, lead screening. But the big thing is vaccines.
And I know a lot of people are concerned about whooping cough now.
Exactly.
That has happened again,
and
so.
The problem is that young adults, the older kids, and adults, not going back and getting those boosters. And then we're the ones actually giving it to the younger kids. So,
Dr. Wright, we appreciate your time.
Thanks
for the insight.
Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Everybody go back to school healthy.